The results are mostly in after a big night in Minnesota politics. Last night, Republicans and DFLers and independents met for the precinct caucuses.
Yeah, big night last night. This is where all the passionate party members decide who they'd like to see become the next governor or senator. Let us bring in Naomi Peskovitz with some early results this morning.
Yeah, and guys, though most of the major parties met for these caucuses, only the GOP had these straw polls just to get those initial votes because they're not facing incumbents for governor and for senator here. On the DFL front, it is now assumed that Senator Al Franken and Governor Mark Dayton will be renominated. For the GOP straw polls, though, about 98% of precincts are now reporting. So let's start with the governor's race here. These are the latest numbers we have. You can see Marty Seifert is in the lead with 28%, followed closely by Dave Thompson with 26%. Jeff Johnson, Scott Honor, Kurt Zellers, and Rob Farnsworth finished out the pack. And here's a look at the hundreds who turned out for the GOP caucuses at Eden Prairie High School. Candidates met with voters and spoke to the crowd before the straw poll started. Now, with a very open race and six candidates, we spoke with Dave Thompson, who placed second, about what he believes sets him apart.
I'm trying to sell myself as somebody that can talk about the things we believe in a way that's going to get all Republicans interested, but just as importantly, get, you know, independents and open-minded Democrats to come out and vote for me.
And now to the GOP race for the Senate nomination. Julianne Ortman is in the lead with 31%. She is followed by Mike McFadden, Jim Abler, and Chris Dahlberg. We did speak to McFadden about his goals for the campaign.
We've worked really hard and we'll continue to work hard, but our focus is on beating Al Franken, and we're making great progress. Every day when I get up, the first thing I'm thinking about is how do we beat Franken, and that's what the campaign thinks about, and this is another step towards that goal.
So this could be a very fierce election season. These results are not binding, just an early way to show support. Later this year, the parties will officially pick their nominees. Some candidates have said they will drop out if they don't get the nomination. Others say they're going for the primary no matter what.
And one of these caucus meetings got kind of interesting last night.
Yeah, you could call it interesting. A little maybe scary for some folks. It happened during the caucus for the Cedar Riverside neighborhood, a DFL caucus there. Police tell us that they had to go in more than once to actually break up some screaming, yelling, pushing, shoving. It was funny. One of our producers was just saying, this is sort of common in other countries that they get really, really passionate like that.
In Britain, for one,
not so much
not
in
Minnesota. No arrests.
People,
especially during a caucus, right? We're so early.
They are passionate.
Yes. All right.
Thanks.
Thank you.